I'm Dr. Victoria Martin. I teach physics and I do physics research into particle physics at Edinburgh University. I have a few ideas. One is I'd like to be a florist, actually, and work in a florist shop because I really love the smell of florists. And my father's stepfather was a florist, and I always had that in it. So maybe I would have become a florist. This actually happened at school. So I was studying chemistry. I was doing my chemistry higher. And I was doing a physics higher at the same time. And I really loved chemistry because we got to think about atoms and the nucleus and electrons and things like that. And then one day I realized that looking down inside the atom wasn't chemistry anymore, because it doesn't matter what kind of atom you are, they all look the same inside to some extent. That's physics. And I always was really interested in what an atom looked like inside. And that's what I now understand as particle physics. So it was at school during my hires, and I switched. In one day, I was going to go and do chemistry at university, and the next day, I decided I was going to do physics. And this was actually Peter Higgs himself. So Peter Higgs was one of my lecturers in the very final year of my undergraduate degree at the University of Edinburgh. And he taught a course called Groups and Symmetries. And in that course, he was telling us about a rather complicated mathematical construct that doesn't make too much sense in the kind of world that we live in, but it's really important in particle physics to understand how the particles that we investigate interact. And he just said something at one point which just made me understand, not particularly directly about particle physics, but about the symmetry. And that is related to the Higgs boson that Peter Higgs invented. And I think that was one of the things just in my head that thought, oh, that's really interesting about that symmetry. That's to do with the Higgs boson. You're Peter Higgs. I'd really like to learn more about the Higgs boson. And back then, the Higgs boson was just an idea. We hadn't discovered it. Physicists were looking for it. I wasn't yet an active researcher. But I think that was the spark in my head. The best part of my job is when I actually get to think about the particle physics that I research. So there's a lot of my job that's not as interesting. So I teach physics. We also get grant money in to spend, to do the research, to employ people to be my research assistants and things. And I really like working with them, but the best part is when I actually get to think about the physics that we're doing. So look at some of the data when it's coming in, try and decide what it might mean, because we don't know until we look at it in detail, but just that first look at the data, I think that's the part that I enjoy the most. This is not a very inspired answer. I'd probably like to go back to the age of the dinosaurs. To sit in a tree and watch the dinosaurs. I think that would be fascinating. If I could have two trips, I'd also like to go to the future. And I think I'd like to see some astrophysical phenomena, like a star exploding. That's very dangerous. So we'd have to be fairly far away, but maybe somewhere in the future where I could see a supernova. You could also go to the past and see a supernova, because we know some of them happened, but they're the two things. I'd like to see the dinosaurs, and I'd like to see a supernova as close as safely possible.
I'd first heard that I'd been nominated for a Nobel Prize back in 1980, so I knew what might happen to me.